Okay, January. All right. First, Bad Boys for Life, and now this. Keep it up. Keep the good stuff coming.
There's only one rule in this jungle. When the lion's hungry, he eats.
So The Gentlemen is a new crime comedy film that was written and directed by Guy Ritchie and then stars an ensemble cast that includes Charlie Hunnam, Matthew McConaughey, Colin Farrell, you also have Hugh Grant, amongst many others in this. Getting into the plot of The Gentlemen, I feel like I can only give you guys a very vague description of the synopsis because I feel like if I go any further than what I'm about to say, I'd be spoiling it for you. So this is what I can say about The Gentleman. Matthew McConaughey plays a guy that runs a marijuana business, and Charlie Hunnam plays a character that's essentially his right-hand man. And when Matthew McConaughey's character is trying to make a deal with someone and that deal doesn't really go the way that it's supposed to go, let's just say shit happens. Alrighty guys, so let's get into The Gentleman. The Gentleman was a movie that I was actually looking forward to despite it, yes, being released in January, though I'm gonna repeat the statement that I said when it came to my Bad Boys for Life review. From past experience, when it comes to January movies, specifically from mid to late January, that is where it seems that January has some pretty decent to actually pretty good movies. And I am sorry to say this, guys, The Gentleman is one of those few good January movies. And when I mean this movie is good, I mean I enjoyed the shit out of this movie so damn much. First of all, when it comes to the performances, I gotta say, everyone here absolutely crushes it. I mean, from Matthew McConaughey to Charlie Hunnam, Michelle Dockery, Henry Golding, Colin Farrell, also Hugh Grant, seriously, everyone here does such a great job in this movie. But if I were to give my standouts from The Gentleman, and I just wanna make myself clear here, that's not to discredit everybody else here, because like I mentioned before, everyone here is so good this week. But if I were to give the ones that truly stood out to me the most, easily Charlie Hunnam and Colin Farrell. When it comes to Matthew McConaughey, not only did I think he gave such a great performance, but the dialogue written by Guy Ritchie for him, this is the type of character I could just see Matthew McConaughey having an absolute blast with, and it definitely seems like he was having a blast in his role. When it comes to Charlie Hunnam is a great actor. I mean, if you guys have not seen him in Sons of Anarchy, please do so because he is absolutely phenomenal in it. But here, best performance I've seen from him. There was especially a monologue that he does at one scene particularly. I can't get away because it is a phenomenal scene, but he does this monologue and I was just sucked into the screen right there. I mean, he has such a commanding presence, and I want to see him in even more leading men roles. Regarding Henry Golding, this is actually the first movie that I have seen him in. So yes, I have not seen Crazy Rich Asians, even though people speak very highly about it, and I have not seen Last Christmas. So this was the first time I got to see him, and I gotta say, I can see why people like this guy, because not only is he entertaining, and not only does he have such a presence on the screen, but good God, he is just so good at playing a villain in this movie. And not to mention, I couldn't get enough of him in this movie, like everybody else, really. But like I mentioned before, I loved Colin Farrell. The moment that he came on screen, I don't know what it was, but I thought the movie picked up right there. He had me cracking up as so much, oh my God, especially in his opening introductory scene. I could not stop laughing. And Michelle Dockery in this movie also has a couple of scene-stealing scenes. One particular, goddamn, I was not expecting to happen at all. And here's the thing as well. Even though Guy Ritchie has gotten together such an amazing cast, one of the things I was worried about when it came to this movie is that I was really concerned that every actor wouldn't get their time to shine, where no. Every actor in this movie has their time in the spotlight, and each actor in this movie has such phenomenal moments. One of the things that I loved about The Gentleman is that after the film's first act, to which I'll get to in a little bit, this movie, after the end of the first act, is one of the most entertaining times I've had at the movies in a long time. And there is just non-stop entertainment and hilarity at scene from scene from scene. And getting right into it, something that I loved about this movie as well is that this movie is fucking hilarious. And I mean, this movie is hysterical. The Gentleman has so many not only funny as hell moments, but there are so many lines, especially spoken by Colin Farrell, that had me cracking the fuck up. Especially if you see the trailer where he says, the fuck guy, That scene had me dying. I was laughing so hard. Even in the film's opening act, it is still absolutely hilarious. Seriously, from moment one, I could not stop laughing in this movie. Something else that I particularly loved about The Gentlemen was not only how meta it was. I mean, this movie is meta, and I don't want to go further than saying meta, because if I do, it's spoilers. Not only how meta this movie was, but just how smart and how unpredictable this movie was. And to add even more on top of that, there were so many moments in this film that I did not see coming. I mean, there was one that literally had me going like, whoa! I mean, goddamn. One particular thing that a lot of people are saying is that this movie is a return to form to Guy Ritchie's earlier works like Snatch, Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels, to which I'm gonna say right here, I have not seen those films. I know I need to go see them, so I can't really comment on that. I like The Gentlemen so much, and hearing about these comments makes me want to see Snatch and Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels just to see the praise that everyone's been talking about. And plus, I am a big Guy Ritchie fan, so it makes me want to see those movies now. And one thing that I loved about this movie as well is that there was a certain point in this movie into which it felt like that Charlie Hunnam was speaking for the audience. Then Guy Ritchie was like, okay guys, I know what you want, let's get this party started here. And the other thing that I loved about The Gentlemen was the film's ending. Literally, I was like this in the theater. Guy Ritchie, you brilliant bastard. I mean, damn, that was an ending right there. As far as my issues go, I do have a few. One, I mean, the first act. I honestly thought that the first act of The Gentlemen was not only really hard to follow and kind of confusing, because Guy Ritchie goes into so many directions, but I was actually kind of bored in the first act. Also, due to that first act, this movie feels like it runs a tad bit too long. The movie is like, what, an hour 45? I feel like you could have cut out 5, maybe 10 minutes of this movie, and then this movie would have been really streamlined. And I guess if I had to really reach for another issue I had, was that there was an actor in this movie, I think his name is Jeremy Strong, who plays a character in this movie. I feel like that he didn't get enough screen time. I mean, granted, he is still great in this movie. He is great, but I feel like that he didn't get enough screen time given his role in the movie. So overall, The Gentlemen was a hell of an entertaining thrill ride. While the first act is a bit hard to follow and it does get a tad bit boring here and there, once you do get past that first 20 minutes, you are in for one great time of the movies. All in all, I had a hell of a great time with The Gentlemen, so I am going to give The Gentlemen a 4 out of 5 stars. Such an entertaining crime movie from Guy Ritchie. If you're a big fan of Guy Ritchie, definitely see this movie. If you're not a fan of his though, you may not like this one, just saying. Alrighty guys, so comment out and let me know below, what is your favorite Guy Ritchie film? Let me know below. If you guys want to follow me on social media, I'm on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Twitch. I'm also on Snapchat and Stardust. So if you want to follow me on all those social media platforms, all the links and usernames are in the description below. I hope you guys enjoyed my review of The Gentlemen. If so, please hit that like button, also subscribe, and don't forget to hit that notification bell for whenever a new video of mine goes live. If you guys want to see any of my previous two videos, please click either right there or there. And of course, until my next video or review, I will see you guys next time.